Hi, everybody. I'm wondering if you've ever had a heart-to-heart with God. If you've ever had this moment where you've heard an audible voice. I had this experience not a lot of times, but there was one time that I actually did have this experience. I had gone to Whitworth. I was a religion major. I had studied scripture. I had grown up in a ministry family. And right after graduating Whitworth, I stayed here in Spokane, and I worked on Young Life staff for 3 full years. At the end of that 3rd year, I really started wondering what I was going to do with my life, and if ministry was really the call that God had placed on my heart. So I decided to take a break. I packed up everything I had, which wasn't much, but I moved to Portland with some girlfriends, and I started working at Banana Republic. I did no ministry at all that year, and I spent hours upon hours just folding cashmere in retail and talking to people coming through the store. And during that year, I spent a lot of time wondering, what am I doing with my life? Completely stuck. And there was one fall afternoon that I took a run in Portland. I remember it was raining, and I had my headphones on. I was going up this hill, and it was this clear, audible voice that I heard saying, "My plans for your life are bigger and better than your plans are for your life." And I remember I was stopped in my tracks, like, what? What? And I kept hearing it over and over for days to come. My plans for your life are bigger and better than your plans are for your life. It was a couple weeks later that I went up to a big church in Seattle. I was visiting my sister, and I sat there, and a young woman walked up into the pulpit in her clergy robe, and she started to preach. And I sat there and cried, because I knew that that was an invitation for me to begin my journey and to head towards seminary. There's a story in Genesis in chapter 12, and God comes to Abram, and he says, "I want you to pack up everything that you have, your family, everything that you own, all of your livestock, and I would love for you to travel to this unknown land called Canaan. And there, I'm going to set up a whole new nation for you, and I'm going to bless you." And Abram didn't know what he was walking into. He was 75 years old. He wasn't looking for this huge transition, but he heard this voice of God. He had this interaction with him. And because of that, he was faithful. He packed up everything, and he headed toward this unknown land. And the scripture says when he got there, he built an altar. And this altar is so significant because in Hebrew, altar actually means a place of nourishment. It means a place where you mark this heart-to-heart that you have had with God, that there's this reminder that you've had this interaction. And so Abram builds an altar. And this altar alters everything. His whole life is changed in a way that the trajectory of his life is moved into a whole new direction. And the scriptures go on to say, even after that, he moved again because he heard the voice of God, and there he built another altar. And so it made me think about, how do we understand our experiences with God? Could we begin to think about them in places where we've heard or interacted with the living God, with Jesus Christ, maybe the Holy Spirit, and if we were to be people that marked those moments with altars? So as we look back on our life, we'll have altar after altar as a reminder of God's faithfulness. Even in the hard times and the good times, that there can be these places where we remember that God has been faithful and that he promises to bless us.